Good morning, students. I hope you will enjoy this class today. It will be a video sent to you as we have started the third lesson in history, the farmers and the herders. So we have completed half of the lesson yesterday. That was Neolithic or New Stone Age, and what did early man did in that this period? He started cultivating plants, using polished stone tools, domesticating animals, settling in villages. And what were the changes brought about by agriculture? The first biggest change was first settlements, domestication of animals and plants, improved tools. This we have done yesterday. Now today we will come to know about the new and more sophisticated pottery in the period of Neolithic age. Now food production grew due to farming, and there was a need to surplus food. At first, baskets were woven from wild grass. Now, as they started growing the crops in large quantity, so they need to store them also. So they started weaving the baskets with the wild grass. Later, these were plastered with wet clay to make them more beautiful. Since fire has been discovered, so clay pots were baked and used to store food and even liquids also. They started storing the liquid as well. Then large-scale building activities. Building was another area in which Neolithic people made remarkable progress. They used mud bricks to construct houses. So by that time they come to know that you have to use the mud bricks to construct the houses. The best example of this can be Cattle Hayuk in West Asia. This also built tombs to bury the dead. So they started building the tombs also, because they have developed how to make the mud bricks. So in respect of houses, by the side, they started making the tombs also to bury the dead. In Europe, particularly in Ireland, many such tombs still exist. Means you can still see the such kind of tombs which were made at that time in Europe. Now, invention of wheel, that was also a very remarkable invention. The invention of the wheel is one of man's greatest achievement, as it made life faster and smoother. The first fire were discovered, and after that invention of wheel was there. Then with the help of the wheel, heavy objects could be transported easily. Now in addition to transport, the wheel was also used to make pots and for spinning and weaving. Though man has started cultivation and his activities were increasing day by day, so they need to just transport the goods also. So this wheel really helped them a lot and make their life faster and smoother. Before wheel, if they have to carry the logs of wood or whatsoever other things they have to carry from one place to another, it is very hard to carry them, even the surplus quantity of crops. So with the help of wheel, they made it faster also and smoother also. As you can see here in this picture, Stone Age wheel, how easily they can carry the products from one place to another. Then after this, it comes the Chalcolithic age. It was the period between 4000 to 2000 BCE. Now following agriculture, the discovery and use of metal marks the next major milestones in the progress of civilization. Copper was the first metal to be discovered and used by man. As man started making pottery, making mud houses, but by this time in the Chalcolithic age is so important, it is very important, because in this period copper was discovered. Copper was the first metal to be discovered by and used by man. It could be shaped into various tools. The period when man used both copper and stone tools is called Chalcolithic age or the copper age. So this was the period when man started using copper also in their tools. So this is also called copper age. Now customs, practices and religious life. Now how was the custom, practices and religious life एट द टाइम ऑफ न्यूलॉथिक एज, ड्यूरिंग द न्यूलॉथिक एंड चालकोलिथिक एजेस, मैन वॉज स्केयर्ड ऑफ नेचुरल फिनोमिना सच एज लाइटनिंग, थंडरस्टॉर्म्स एंड फॉरेस्ट फायर्स. सो ही डिडंट नो अबाउट दिस नेचुरल फिनोमिना, ही वॉज रियली scared. If he used to see lightning or thunderstorms and forest fires happening in the forest, he did not understand what made them take place. Kis wajah se ye hota hai? So he began to worship forces of nature like the sun, rain, thunder and earth. So they started worshipping all them so that these things do not happen in future. Earth was revered as a mother as it provided food. So see, they started worshipping mother also. They started considering earth as a mother, mother earth, as it provided food to them, because they are the main thing which is needed for their survival was the food, and this mother earth is only giving food to them. So they have started considering earth as a mother. Now time to think. What were Stone Age wheels made of? Can you think? Yes, it was made of wood. Yes. Now, burials. Neolithic and Chalcolithic people looked upon death as a journey from which one did not return. They believed in life after that. So, when a person passed away, he was buried with his belongings such as baskets, stone tools and jewelry. So, the people who died, they were buried with the baskets, stone tools and jewelry. Now, here is a case study of Mehrgarh. Mehrgarh is in Pakistan. Is one of the earliest sites of Neolithic culture. It dates between 7000 and 5500 BCE. The site was discovered by a French team led by Jean-Francois Jarrett. The team excavated this site between 1974 and 1986. So this was the site which was excavated, means archaeologists excavated this site in 74 to 86, that is 1974 to 1986. It is present in Pakistan. The site shows evidence of cultivation of wheat, barley, and domestication of cattle, sheep, and goats. People lived in mud brick houses and had granaries to store crops. So these all things were present there, which gives the example of Neolithic age. Tools made from animals' bone were very much in use. Neolithic inhabitants of Mehrgarh wove basket, probably of wild grass, which were lined with bitumen. Bitumen, I told you, it is a black material. It is a black material which is covered, the layer of which was covered on the baskets to make it harder. The earliest ground stone axe was found here. Ornaments of seashells, beads, limestone, turquoise, lapis lazuli, sandstone, polished copper have been found. Along with simple figures of women and animals, these designs perhaps had some religious significance. So these pottery was all made with beautifully decorated with various designs. And but they have some religious significance, making those designs on the pottery. And the ornaments, these ornaments were made of various polished copper or the sandstone or the different seashells, beads. Many burial sites have been found at Mehrgarh. At one burial, a skeleton of a goat has been found. It was probably buried to serve as food for a dead man. So in case if they have buried a goat, so it means that this must be they must be thinking that this is a food which dead men can have. Mehrgarh was occupied continuously until about 2600 BCE, when it was abandoned. In the Deccan, many burial sites were marked with huge blocks of stone called megaliths. So in Mehrgarh, the it was continuously means abandoned. Okay, until 2600 BCE in the Deccan when burial sites were marked with huge blocks of stone. Now here in the Deccan we can see the huge blocks of stones that is called megaliths, where the dead people were buried and very huge blocks of stone were kept on that. Those are called megaliths, so that it can be recognized easily that these are the burial sites.